As we know, drinking too much alcohol may cause your liver damage and leads to liver cirrhosis and then cancer. So the goal of our laboratory at the National Institute of Health is trying to understand how alcohol drinking causes liver damage and liver cancer. Particularly, we want to know how immune cells participate in alcohol-induced liver injury, how genetic factors and dietary factors, aging, etc., modulate alcoholic liver disease and injury.
And so I'm working on a new mouse model of alcoholic liver disease that we recently developed. And so this model incorporates both chronic and binge drinking to mimic the drinking pattern in humans. And it closely replicates some features of the human alcoholic liver disease. And so this new model can be used to study the pathogenesis of alcoholic liver disease and can also be used to explore new therapeutic targets for this disorder. So those cells are mouse hepatocytes, and we are using them to incubate with different inflammatory cytokine or with alcohol to study the response of these cells to this stimuli.
So I was interested in looking at a few different dietary aspects. For example, here in America, you always hear about the Western diet and how that's high in fat and high in sugar. So I was interested in looking at that, but I was also interested in looking at other things, for example, high fat diet by itself, high sugar, because we have the issue with the sodas and the high fructose corn syrup, and then also high cholesterol, because that also seems to be an issue in the American diet. So I'm very interested in seeing how those different dietary aspects might affect the progression of alcoholic liver injury. So what we have here are different diets using our rodent model. So at the very end, those light brown pellets, that's just the regular diet that the mice are usually on. Next to that, we have a very high fat diet. These light colored pellets here are the Western diet. So those are high in fat, high in sugar, and slightly different fat composition as those. Here, the light blue is a high sugar diet alone. And then I was also interested in looking at the combination of high fat and high sugar, so that's with the pink pellets. And then here, the light green, we have the high cholesterol diet. And then after these mice feed on these for 12 weeks, then I will give them binge alcohol and see how that affects the alcoholic liver injury.
So in order to look at the overall morphology of liver, we first have to embed them using wax. So these are liver samples, and they have already been fixed. So now what Dr. Matthews is doing is she's embedding them into wax. And once they're all placed in order, she's gonna put them in a platform that is cold, that it's gonna solidify the wax. And in order to get slices, then you have to use a microtome and put them into a slide, and then you can do different types of stainings in order to visualize whether there's fat in the liver or just to get a quick look at the overall morphology. So this is a hepatocyte, a liver cell. This is what we consider to be a nicely arranged morphology, because hepatocytes are a type of liver cells and they're arranged in a nicely ordered. So when you have ethanol exposure, that array is actually disorganized and becomes dysregulated due to these lipid or fat accumulation in the liver.
You know, one of major projects in our lab is trying to study how genetic factors may affect alcoholic liver disease. For example, one of the key enzymes to metabolize alcohol is acetaldehyde dehydrogenase, ALDH2. In Asia, 50 to 60% of Asian population actually have the ALDH2 very low activity. So those people who are drinking alcohol may develop a high level of acetaldehyde, causing the flushing syndrome, the red face. So we actually trying to understand how this enzyme deficiency may affect liver injury, liver inflammation, even liver cancer. So hopefully we study this animal model, then we may move to the clinical study to identify those the function of ALDH2 and liver inflammation, injury, and cancer.
So this one with low FSC, SSC, this is the lymphocytes.
Mm-hmm.
And here the SSC is much higher because it means that the cell have lots of vascular structure, it's a neutrophils.
Okay.
So my work just to confirm the finding by our colleagues to verify the role of immune cells in the development of alcoholic liver disease. So by collaborating with Dr. Xu-Bin Qing in Temple University, we have generated a special transgenic mice. By using the mice, when we inject some drug, we can specifically kill some certain immune cells like neutrophils here. By injecting mice with drug, it can kill the neutrophils in very short time, like 10 minutes. Because the traditional method can also do that, but it takes around 2 or 3 days. Our technique is much faster and powerful. So first, we should verify the role of neutrophils in the development of alcoholic liver disease, and maybe other cells also involved. We are planning to do that, to deplete different kind of immune cells to see what happened to liver alcoholic liver disease. And for the hepatocyte, we can study the liver regeneration. So when the hepatocyte was depleted, and we see how long it will take for the liver to recover, to regenerate, and we can study the whole process. We have traditional models to study liver regeneration, but this one provides a new model, because traditional one just needs surgery. This one, we just need to inject some drug. So that's the advantage. When you inject something, you do see something changed. That's very, very exciting. No one sees that before. I'm the first one to see that. It's really, really exciting.
Alcoholic liver disease, especially the severe form of alcoholic liver disease, is very difficult to treat. And there's no FDA approved therapy for this disease. The number of alcoholic liver disease in the US is more than 2 million Americans who are affected by alcoholic liver disease. So the final goal of our lab is trying to identify effective therapy to treat this disease. Recently, we have demonstrated that interleukin 22 is a key survival factor for the liver cells. Those study result is being translated into the clinical study. Interleukin 22 is mainly produced by immune cells, but the immune cells do not have a receptor for this interleukin 22. So interleukin 22 does not come back and target immune cells. Instead, they specifically target the liver cells, like a hepatocyte. So the side effect of interleukin 22 treatment should be very minimal, because they are very specific target hepatocyte and other epithelial cells, not immune cells. The clinical trial for the interleukin 22 for the treatment of alcoholic liver disease is under the investigation. Hopefully in the future, we have some drugs that can be used for the treatment of alcoholic liver disease, so it's beneficial for the liver disease patient.